Thank you, Mr. Chairman. First of all, I want to thank Chairman Micah and Member Ray Hall for their work in bringing the FAA bill to the floor. But I particularly want to thank Mr. Costello, because without his leadership and working this bill through for many years, we would not have a bill on the floor, and the public really owes you a great debt of gratitude, and I want to thank you. And, you know, I think the aviation community deserves a long-term aviation bill so they can plan for the future needs of the traveling public. We have had 23 extensions already, and it's really time to send a bill to the president. But this is not a perfect bill, and I don't support the labor compromises in this bill and don't believe it should have been in the aviation bill in the first place. But our airports, airlines, and passengers have waited too long for this important safety provisions. My home state of Florida rely on air service to support our tourist-based economy. We have 20 primary airports, 22 reliever airports, and 57 general aviation airports, with our top three airports generating close to $45 million in employments a year. This airport creates jobs and help grow the economy. And I really got to say that if we don't pass this, that probably will not be any transportation or putting people to work. Because the piece that we passed 3 o'clock this morning out of the transportation committee is the worst bill I have seen in the 30 years I've been elected. I've been in transportation 10 years in the Florida House and close to 20 here, and it was truly the worst bill I ever seen. When people from California went into the bill and took almost $1 billion from the people from California, people from Houston took it, not only taking the safety of the public, I mean, taking the transportation dollars, doing away with all of the regulations. May I have an additional minute? It is truly sad day for transportation, and this will probably be our only work product, because, you know, members come to the floor and they rail about the Senate. Well, let me tell you something. The Senate don't have to take up our bad work. And in fact, this bill, this transportation bill, should be dead on arrival when it gets to the Senate. And I will do all I can to continue to work, to put people to work, and work for making sure that we have a transportation and infrastructure bill that will really put people to work. Because we know for every $1 billion we spend, it generates 44,000 jobs. Truly the worst bill I've ever seen.